My name is Meg Turney. I'm a host at Rooster Teeth, and I also do cosplay. I started cosplaying 15 years ago as a nerdy little kid at a convention. I basically came to my very first anime convention and had heard about this thing where people dressed up in costumes. I saw everybody dressed up in these really colorful, crazy, awesome costumes and was hooked. I wanted to know how I could do it, how I could join in on the fun. So my first cosplay that I ever put together was Sailor Heavy Metal Papillon. I was 15 at the time, and I just hot glued everything together. It was an absolute disaster of a cosplay, but I had a lot of fun, and I found a passion for something that I continue to do today. My proudest cosplay achievement is probably my Amekami Zatanna, which is an anime comic book mashup of popular comic book characters. And Zatanna is such a cool character, and she's so powerful, but with an anime twist, I got to do some really cute stuff with her as well. The construction of the costume was easily the hardest thing I had taken on at the time. I did a fully lined magician's coat. I also did this, she has these really like gravity-defying tails that come off her corset. So it was really, really fun to put that together and to actually take it out to San Diego Comic-Con. For me, no one gets to define cosplay except the cosplayer themselves. No one can say that's not cosplay. And the people that do say that's not cosplay just bring negativity into our space. I just don't think that you can tell anyone what they do isn't cosplay. If you think you're having fun and you've created an underwear outfit of a character that you love, cool, you created something. Like, at the end of the day, it's most important to focus on the fact that we're all creating things that we love and that we love to do. If you're happy and comfortable in the costume you made, screw everybody else. Like, just have fun. Absolutely, I've had a negative experience in the cosplay that I was wearing. I did a documentary with a Nerdist once called Cosplay 101, and in that cosplay documentary, I cosplayed Judy from Cowboy Bebop, and Judy wears a big blue coat, but it's split down the center of the chest and kind of stuck to her, so the entire center of your chest is bare. It's actually less cleavage than you would see anywhere at the beach or even most cosplay costumes, but because it's the center of your chest, a lot of people see it as very risque. And a woman, it's in the documentary, a woman actually stopped me on the street and yelled at me and said that children didn't need to see what I was wearing, and her kids were in a cheerleading competition in tiny little skirts too, so it was a little weird, but you brush it off and realize that people are lashing out at you for whatever reason. I mean, hurt people, right? So, yeah. On the subject of booth babes, honestly, I don't see a problem with booth babes at all, especially at places like E3, at a Comic-Con. When you hire models to wear a costume, they're doing exactly what they're supposed to do. They're drawing people into your booth. They're talking about, they usually have to memorize a lot of literature about what they're talking or what they're representing or what they're gonna be talking about. And I don't know if that I would call those people cosplayers, I would call them models, but whether or not they should be banned from a convention, I don't see it. I can understand having guidelines for what can and can't be shown, absolutely. There are always guidelines for cosplayers as well, and sometimes cosplayers get caught out on those, and that's really on the cosplayer. You should always know the guidelines for the convention you're attending, but just to have somebody as a model dress up in a costume and to call that unfair or not cool or that it's a bannable offense is very silly to me.